Hello and welcome to your daily dose of Advanced 3062, the updated mod that includes a fully functional star map of the BattleTech universe, and it's been a lot of fun. So one of the things we're going to do today to start off is there's a new mission type included in this mech. It's called this mod. It's called a duo duel. I've never played it before, but basically pair of mech warriors have eloped and they took their mechs and they defected to the enemy. So the Steiner Intersphere House would like us to track down these two mech warriors and get their mechs back. So the thing here is they only let you take two mechs because it's supposed to be a solo duel, a duo duel. So the question is, as more likely than not in these situations, is are we then going to be hit by reinforcements and it's going to not be a two-on-two deal, it's going to be like, I don't know, 2-on-8 or something crazy like that. So let's see what happens. Right, here we are. So we're in the dual space. Those of you that played the campaign will recognize this is where the last battle of the base game took place. So you're basically in this arena. And what I chose to do with this mission is I took my crab, my HD crab, which is pretty much invulnerable, and I'm going to have it tank. And then I took my wolfhound, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to let my crab tank, and then I'm going to let my wolfhound go around and shoot these guys in the rear. We'll see if it works. Seems like the best avenue here. Now, if my wolfhound gets shot before it gets around to the rear, we're going to have problems. So we got a quick draw and a quick draw. So we got two quick draws. All right, so they technically they out-ton me. Good hit percentages here. So we'll go ahead and hit the first quick draw as we run to the rear. All right, now we need to push our crab forward and make it the primary target here. So let's hit hard. That's a good start. Jumping to cover, and they're going after the crab, which is exactly what I was hoping for. And we're going to keep our wolfhound working on getting to the rear. Guys are evasive, so we can actually use a precision strike to increase our chances of a hit. Let's go for one of the legs. Yeah, we missed. That's okay. These guys are going to use their evasion. As their key. The same way I'm using the crab's super hard shell as one of my keys for this, so I think pretty good here. One quick draw is already in trouble. As long as they don't tag my wolfhound too badly. Alright, let's see what this quick draw does. It's going to move forward. Are they coming in for melee? They are. And they missed. Now that was a mistake, because when you go in for melee, you lose evasion, which is the best advantage these quick draws had going for them, was keeping their evasion high. And now our wolfhound is in the rear. That's not going to be good for them. Alright, so we're actually going to try to stretch this out as long as possible. So we'll get into cover. Force this quick draw to keep chasing me. Coming after the crab. Ace pilot. Wow, I didn't even know you could jump up there. Huh. I didn't know you could jump up to the top of the arena. I guess it makes sense, but I've never seen anybody do that before. Alright, while there. You need to keep your evasion high. Cool off in the water while we're at it. See, the AI at least figured out that they couldn't let me just keep shooting them in the back with my wolfhound. So the wolf, they actually did something pretty smart by putting their back to the wall, so to speak. We're going to keep playing for time because my armor is such that I can keep taking these hits, but these quick draws are getting torn up pretty quickly. Alright, there goes a pilot injury. There's a quick draws coming in for melee again. Yep. That's okay. Got tons of armor on this crab, so that's the whole reason I picked this duo. I took the advantage of the HD's strong armor and the mobility of the wolfhound, and I'm trying to use those strengths to my advantage here. Alright, now the wolfhound can get another shot to the rear. This quick draw. And miss. Okay. It's gonna happen. And the good news is I've suffered no damage here. And we're gonna keep backing up. Extending this battle. Keep coming after the crab. That quick draw's going to the water because it was overheating. Alright, that other quick draw's going to cover. Trying to buy some time. The one thing about this quick drive going to the water is it lost a lot of its evasion. Just keep hitting it in the rear. Keep hitting the guy in the water because he's got no cover. So let's use a precision strike here. Go for a leg. Just can't push. They just can't crack through that crab shell. I love these HD crabs. They're the best tankers and grinders I've seen. Because there's nothing they could do. They can't get through the armor in the time that it's taking my wolf hand to just tear them apart from behind. Plus, the crab originally just came with 5 medium lasers, but I put in an XL engine, which allowed me to put a large laser in, so it actually has some punch now. Finally started attacking the wolfhound again. So we're going to have to get the wolfhound's evasion up. Alright, another melee attack. That's okay. We can handle that. Alright, so let's get the wolfhound's evasion up. Again. Flanking this guy. There goes a leg. And you know what? We're just going to go for melee here. An ejection. So much to death do us part, because one of them said, I'm out of here. Uh-oh. Oh, finally got through that crab armor. Okay, that's fine. That's the last shot you're going to take on us, buddy. You are in trouble. Alright, super precision strike here. There we go. Alright, that's the end of the duel. Was a straightforward mission and not a trick. I fully expected us to be defeating them and then have, oh, here comes some reinforcements. What happened to a fair fight? Alright, so a crab got a little bit of damage. Nothing it can't handle. Alright, we get one quick draw part. Unless there's something better. Ooh. Alright, so I actually could use this core. more than I can use the quick draw part, actually. So we'll get the quick draw part and a core. That core will come in handy. So there you go. There's a new mission type that's available with this updated mod. So I like the fact that the modder not only gave us a star map, but they gave us some new mission types. They've also created some stories. And added some depth to things like incidences while you're traveling. It's a very cool new mod. All right, let's go to the mech bay here. A little bummed that my crab got damaged a little bit. One day to repair. All right, I'm gonna wait the one day for my crab, because it's one of my favorite mechs right now. So we'll wait the extra day. You know what? Let's wait one more day. We'll get the trebuchet back. All right, we completed the power conduits. So let's give engineering something else to work on. Let's do the structural repair. I want to get to the point where I can have 3 mech bays, because I'm running out of room in my mech bay. Alright, let's find another mission. We probably have time for one more mission. We got an eviction mission, capture base mission, biological sample mission. Escort mission. Let's do the biological sample mission. Usually those are pretty quick, and then maybe we can get in one more mission. All right. This wolfhound as my scout. It's worked out really well. Let's see. We'll take the trebuchet for support. And let's see. Put that in the fourth slot. Mustang does pretty good with the trebuchet. And we're going to take our repaired crab. Sarge in there. And here we go. Really enjoying this updated mod. It's like a whole, you know, mods are, so one of the reasons BattleTech works as long as it does is each time they came out with a DLC, it felt like it was a new game. Each time I found a cool new mod, it felt like a new game. And right now, it's still feeling like a new game. I would say like a sequel to a game that I love. So that's what it feels like. should be loaded up anytime now. Should be up any minute now. There we go. Modern Battletech does take a little longer than traditional Battletech to load up. It's just part of the fact that there's so much more data that they have to load into the scenario. Especially since this mod actually increases the size of the maps. Alright, where are we supposed to go? Oh boy. Alright, this is going to be a long slog across the map. Alright. Alright, how are we going to even get there? I guess we could cross there. Okay. All right, we're gonna have a bit of a walk here, which is not good because my crab is a little slow. So is my hunchback. Find us the way. The Centurion's fairly fast. The Hunchback is slow. Our crab isn't too bad. And the Trebuchet is pretty quick, actually. Got enemy contact already. Good, because that will cause our lance to bunch up, which is what we want right now. Because if I let every mech go at max speed towards the objective, we're going to be strung out and on our own, which is not what we want. Alright, now we're entering into combat. Alright, let's see if... We can at least get vision on one target. Alright, we've got four targets between us and the initial location. Alright, we got a Jenner, and we have really good hit percentages on this Jenner, so we have to take this shot. Alright, got one hit in before the Jenner got evasive. And let's actually take advantage of that right now. Make sure that we make advantage, take the most of the fact that that Jenner is not evasive right now. Try to hit it hard. Not as hard as I would have liked. Centurion can't quite get in range yet, so we'll just close the distance. wolfhound, which is fine. It's got really high evasion. It's going to take a while for our crab to get into position. Jenner's moving up. Good luck getting our hunchback into position anytime soon. Really need to replace this hunchback with something faster. But the hunchback has a punch that I'm not ready to give up. All right, and he's moving to contact, that's good. Gonna have to keep the Centurion evasive. It doesn't have a ton of armor on it. Here comes a 40-tonner. Wonder if it's a cicada or maybe a Vulcan. Oh, that's a Vulcan. Because it just shot its AC-2s at me. So this is a Vulcan. 90% sure that's a Vulcan. Alright, another missile salvo. This. Oh wow, there is a lot of enemies. So what, basically both of these locations have a lance defending it, and now both of the lances are heading our way. So we got a lot of enemies coming our way, which is fine. The hit percentages here are pretty lousy. So let's actually do a sensor lock on this Jenner. We're gonna have to pull the Wolfhound back. I didn't realize there's quite so many enemies coming at us all at once. We're gonna wanna extend this battle. Alright, so one good thing about when an enemy is a light and it has good evasion, one of the ways you can take that away, good old fashioned melee. Ooh, Gauss rifle shot. Alright, there's a hunchback with a Gauss rifle. That's a problem. That is a problem. Because basically, that's a big problem. Alright, now the good news is it's actually in range. Now there's also a blackjack up there. So let's do a precision strike. Biggest threat right now, I would argue, is the hunchback with the Gauss rifle. We're going to try to work on that, hopefully break the Gauss rifle with a good shot. All right, they're going to keep hitting the Wolfhound. Move up our trebuchet. Trebuchet has good shots at the hunchback. Alright, so we'll do multi-target here. take some shots at that locust. We'll probably miss all those, but... Hopefully we'll beat up this hunchback pretty good. It's a start. Ooh, already structural damage on our centurion. That's not good. Fifty-fifty shot with our large laser. 1% miss. Ooh. Alright. Going after my centurion. So the centurion needs to get to cover from direct fire. There's that Vulcan. Going after our Centurion again. Our Centurion's in definite trouble here. Can I get a turn, please? So attacking our wolfhound. Desperately need Rhino to be a target right now. So let's do that. He's got good shots at this hunchback, so let's. Alright. Two hits there. One of the benefits of the enemy clustering around. Just keep making things worse for our poor centurion. Alright, see, this is the mistake I made by rushing my centurion forward. So the best thing I can do now is put my centurion under cover from direct shots, especially that Gauss rifle. They're going after the wolfhound. As long as they don't hit his leg, we should be okay. Alright, now we gotta push forward with everybody else. So they forget about my centurion for a couple rounds. Ooh, really good shots here on this Jenner. See if we can get this Jenner out of here, because the Jenner is providing vision. Going after the Wolfhound again, that's fine. As long as I keep the Wolfhound evasive, it should be okay. Alright, Sarge. You need to push forward and be a target with that crab. That's what you're there for. And maybe finish off this Jenner? Question mark. There we go. move up the trebuchet. Definitely want to keep hitting that hunchback, so let's do multi-target. Hunchback. And then the locust here. Probably not going to hit it. I just want to break that Gauss rifle. That's my hope. Alright, we've got a narc on that locust. That'll help. Putting it in a position where they have to go after the wolfhound because that's their best shot. And I need the wolfhound to be a distraction right now. It should be able to handle it for a couple rounds. Let's see what the hunchback does. Unless. See, if the wolfhound loses a leg, then we're in serious trouble. Pushing the locust forward so we can get vision. Alright, Rhino needs to stay evasive. Ooh, good shots at our hunchback here. Let's take a precision strike. Go in and get melee on this locust would be nice. That's the blackjack going after. Going after the trebuchet, okay. I can live with that. Do melee again on this locust. If a locust just is going to stand there with low evasion, I'm going to take those shots all day long. There we go. There goes that locust. Hunchback with the Gauss rifle is out of cover. Let's take advantage of that. It's panicked. And they have to send someone else forward to get vision. 50-tonner. I think that was the Centurion that we saw earlier. Oh no, melee. Ooh, okay. Got a little too close. Got a little too close to that Vulcan. You're not going to take a Gauss rifle shot, are you? At my wolfhound? No. Gotta get my wolfhound out of here. Problem is, I need to get him someplace. As far away from that Vulcan as I can. I guess this is going to have to be the best move I can make here. Oh, there's an enforcer. Okay. Might as well take the shot at this enforcer here. See what the Vulcan does. Alright, the Vulcan can't close the distance on that turn. Hunchback is getting beat up. First thing I need to do is I need to move up the crab. I'm gonna go after this blackjack here. Have the angle for that Gauss rifle. That's good. Alright, we gotta move up Wildfire to cover. hits on that blackjack. Going after the crab, which is fine. Going after the crab, which is all going along with my plan. Didn't expect to hit on that locust. That's a bonus. Can get to the objective. Alright, I didn't think I'd be able to climb up this cliff face, so that helps actually. First, we need to stay a distraction here. Ooh, good hits on that hunchback. Vulcan switching to going after the crab. I was worried he would go after my wolfhound here. Looks like they're sufficiently distracted by the crab. The HD crab in cover, bulwarked, can take a lot of hits. I mean, it can't do it forever. But it does have 1,000 armor for a 50-ton mech, so... Hitting this hunchback. If we can get rid of this Gauss rifle, we're going to have a lot more options. It's just taking a long time to nibble this guy down. And our crab can't take this forever. Forward. Good hit percentages here. I wish I had a precision strike available. That didn't go so well. Good hit on this hunchback. There we go. Hey, and we got three salvageable parts, which means we'll get a hunchback with a Gauss rifle, which is a nice actual enhancement logically, because take my chance, move my Centurion up. I need the firepower. So many targets still on this map. All right, Rhino. Move up to the first objective. Get those samples. And you've got a great shot at the rear of that blackjack. Might as well take that shot. This mission's going a little longer than I thought, folks, but it's definitely an interesting challenge. It's a puzzle. We kind of have a standoff here. They've got numbers, and they have geographical advantage, and we're trying to offset that. So, biggest problem is this, I can't just shoot LRMs forever. I'm going to run out. I need to push through these guys at some point. That's not a good start. That was pretty bad, Sarge. I don't know how you missed with six weapons, all of which had a 69% hit chance. Eventually, that crab is going to get busted through. The Centurion at the fringe of this battle because I don't want them to start hitting it. That enforcer. Fine. taking a chance moving my trebuchet down. This is risky. Ooh, sometimes risk pays off. Well, you did your share, Mustang, taking out that blackjack. That definitely helps. Just so many enemies on this map, it's crazy. Alright, I'm gonna have to take a risk with our wolfhound here. We gotta break the deadlock. Nice hits there on that blackjack. Very nice. Alright, I knew they'd have to go after the wolfhound after that. But we need to break. We need to push forward in the next round or so. Not ready to push yet. I hate them too. Keep the Centurion in the rear. Good hit percent chance here. Alright, that blackjack can't take too much more. It's repositioning. Decided it was gonna not push forward there. So what we're actually gonna do is we're gonna push forward now. That blackjack pulling back is our opportunity. Bad hit percentages here. We got lucky. Alright, now's the time for us to push forward. Especially, ooh, alright, really good shots here on this blackjack. Hopefully we can take advantage. Now we can push forward to the other side. Alright, they lost their beachhead. on the other side of the river. So now we can kind of push forward. Okay. I keep using this wolfhound. They discovered my centurion again. All right, we need to push forward. Not something I want to necessarily do with my trebuchet. Trebuchet versus enforcer is never a good matchup. Take a chance with our centurion. Keep its evasion high. This enforcer does. Went after the trebuchet. Okay, that's about as good as I could hope for there. And we got an 80 ton vehicle. One problem at a time. Alright, Rhino, you can't help us very much anymore. What I want you to do is head for the secondary target. Keep your evasion high. And give us a good sensor lock on that enforcer. Yeah, good luck hitting that wolfhound at max evasion. Centurion moving. Multi-target. I thought for sure the Enforcer would switch to my Centurion. Good hits on that Enforcer. Very nice. Ooh. All right, good shots on this Vulcan, actually. And we missed. Start crossing this river. Demolisher. Ooh. Ooh, lethal shot on our player character. Fortunately, he can't die. Very lucky. But he'll be out for a while. Probably 60 days, something crazy like that.